heaven, and he took you to heaven. Then he prepared a place for you in heaven, so that you will never forever be sick again, so that you will never forever be dead again, so that anytime you die here, you find yourself there. That was what Jesus Christ did. But he did all of these things in hope that one day you will believe that he actually did it for you. Because you have never started living until the day you believe that he that gives life has actually really died for you. One day, all of us are not going to be here. Who believe that is going to be here forever? What's the name of the local government? Can you be here in the next 1,000 years? Even if you are here, you'll be a problem. Your children will bury you. So time is going to come when, as long as you remain on this earth, your body will die. And when you die, if you don't believe in the one that has died and went to hell and went to heaven for you, you will remain like the dust and you will go like that. And you will never forever ever see your siblings, your brothers, your mother, your father again. What the challenge is this?
Challenge.
You will also perish in hell. Hellfire will burn you well. Let me tell you, hell is real. There is a place called hell. I have been there before. That's why you see me holding microphone. When I went there, it was never a good place to be. And the only thing that will stop you from not going there is to believe in Jesus Christ and to live a life that is pleasing unto Him. While I was praying, the Lord showed me so many things. And I'm telling you, far beyond the things that the Lord showed me. He told me that we should make sure that each and every one is safe. Because you will get healed. You can get delivered. Or you can still go to hellfire. Because the day you miss heaven, you will not miss hell. And the day you go to hell, you can't go to heaven. The day you choose hell, you cannot decide to choose heaven. And everyone in hell today is born again. Everyone in hell right now is born again.
Okay, duk wanda yake gidan wuta ya tuba.
Because the day you go to hell, you realize that you are actually in hell. And you know that Jesus Christ is actually the Lord of all. And he is the one that is supposed to save you from hell. And you are supposed to give your life to him. And that is why at that time you are already born again, but you are born again at the wrong time. There was a story in the Bible of a man that was very rich. And there is another man that is very poor.
You
find it very hard to have food to eat. Sometimes he has to go to the dustbin of that rich man to find food to eat. And that rich man never once upon a time asked him, why? Because the rich people are always comfortable. Many more times when you don't have problems, you don't consider God. Many of you here are here because you want God to heal you. Many of you are here because you want God to give you money. Because I know that you have been to some places before. If there's another place that can give you money, give you healing, you will go. But that's not what God wants for you. God wants to give you eternal life. And that eternal life you can only get it through Jesus Christ. The Bible says time came when the rich man died and the poor man died. And both of them changed realm, they changed dimension. They buried them here on earth. We think the story finished, but another story continued in another place.
When they
went to heaven, the Bible reckoned that the rich man was casted into the lake of fire, into hell. But the poor man was in paradise. And that time, the rich man realized that he has always lived his life wrong, although he is rich. He keep asking and begging God that, oh Father Abraham, that at least they should find a way to send somebody to tell his siblings at home. He said, go and tell my children. They are very rich. But they don't know God. They are very rich. But they are not born again. At that time, he realized that Jesus is actually the way.
But it is
already late. He was told that there is a demarcation, there is a limit. There is no way that no one can go back again to tell anything. Because it is appointed for one to die once after that judgment. Because he now said that there are the laws and there are the prophets. That they have the laws and they have the prophets. And
praise the Lord.
He told them that there is the prophet, there are teachers. They should listen to them on the earth. If they don't listen to them, they will come and end up where the rich man is. Do you know that the things I'm telling you today will stand against you in the day of judgment? That is why we leave from where we are to come to this place. So that we will tell you that Jesus Christ lived and died for you.
So what the Mugam Kuchewa is Almasihu Yamutukumaya Akatashi,
so that you can live and die for him.
So what the Kakasaya,
so that one day when you go to heaven, when you are judged, you will not say that you have never heard about him before. You might be a fine guy, you might be a fine girl. You are a big boy, you are a big girl. Smoking and drinking will not take you to heaven. Fornicating and sleeping around will not take you to heaven. All these things will only make you a very big fool. But there is the pathway to life. There is a way of life. I want you to know that God is interested in you. And it has been like that since many, many generations. The Bible says, except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.
From
the book of John chapter
3,
the Bible speaks about a man named Nicodemus. He was a Pharisee actually. He is like a pastor of this day. But the Bible said that he doesn't even know what it means to be born again. That's to say he's prepared to go to hell. Although he has been preaching and preaching. But he's not a stupid pastor. Because he's not waiting for the day that Jesus will say, depart from me, I do not know you. When you go home, read that John chapter 3. The Bible says he came to Jesus at night. And he asked him, what will I do for me to be born again? What will I do for me to have this eternal life? And he thought Jesus Christ would tell him something very big. And Jesus told him, he said, verily, verily, except a man is born again, he cannot see into the kingdom of God. Except a man is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. When you go downward, you realize the Bible said that for God so loved the world. And he gave his only begotten son, so that whosoever ever believe in him, he will never perish, but he will have eternal life. But the Bible also say that whosoever refuse to believe in him, he is going to perish and is condemned. It doesn't matter whether he's a child or he is an old man. People are born innocent, but they are never born righteous. Every child needs to be born again. Every mother, every father needs to be born again. Because if you are not born again, the devil will be your portion on the last day. Because like I said, Jesus is coming. And he's coming very, very soon. No sinner will ever inherit the kingdom of God. No wicked person will ever inherit the kingdom of God. God love all of us. The sinner, Boko Haram, and everybody. But if you die in your sin, he will hate you so much that he will put you in a fire that will burn forever. You don't want to experience that dimension of God. I know many of you are worried and are troubled. But the Bible speaks in the book of John chapter 14. Jesus Christ speaking said that let not your heart be troubled. You should just believe in me as you believe in God. Because in my father's house up there, there are many houses and mansions. If
there
is not so, I wouldn't have told you. And hereafter, I go to prepare a place for you. So that when you come, you will join me together there. But you now say that I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. And no one coming to the Father except through me. The Bible said there remaineth another rest for the children of God. Yes, you are part of the children of God, but for you to become the sons of God, you must be born again. You must repent of all your sickness, all your sins and all your wickedness. The Bible says with the heart the man believes and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. The problem you have is not that you don't have money. Because as I told you, the rich man went to hell. Do you want me to give you money and still go to hell? Or do you want to be poor and go to heaven? But the sweet information and the sweet truth is this. No man serve God and remain the same. No man pursue after God and end up being poor. We serve a very rich God. So everything you think you are looking for now that will make you to miss heaven is actually supposed to look for you later when you get heaven.
Duk abin da kake gani yana sa ka kana cewa bari in bar maganar Ubangiji saboda in samu wannan abu ba zai kai ko ina ba amma abin da zaka bari saboda ka bi Ubangiji zaka same shi aljanna.
Because the Bible speaking says seek ye first the kingdom of God.
Litafi mai sarki yana ga mana cewa mu nema hanyar Ubangiji tukuna.
And all its righteousness.
Da sannan kuma da bangas kiyarsa gabaki daya.
And all other things will be added unto you.
Sannan duk wani abin da kake tunani Ubangijin Allah zai kara maka.
I believe that Lazarus chose to be a poor man.
Na yadda cewa Lazarus ya zaba ya zama mutumin da bai da arziki.
That story that I gave you.
Wannan labari da muka baku.
Because you can choose to be a very poor Christian and go to heaven.
Zaka iya zama wanda baka da arziki amma kuma zaka sama.
But you can also choose to be rich and still go to heaven.
Sannan zaka iya zaba kuma ka zama mai arziki sannan kuma still.
Because the Bible says Abraham is a man of faith, he believed God.
Litai mai sarki ya ce mana Ibrahim mutumi ne mai ban gaskiya kuma ya yarda da Allah.
But he is very very rich.
Kuma sannan bayan haka mai arziki ne.
And the Bible says that God wish above all things that you prosper.
Tunanin Ubangiji da kuma ban gaskiyar shi shine dukan mu samu ci gaba.
And be in good health.
Sannan mu zama masu cikuna masu lahiya.
But the devil will never want you to succeed without him getting involved.
Sannan shedan baya son ka samu wannan ci gaba ba tare da sa hannunsa ba.
You might be a government worker in this place.
Zai iya zama na kai ma'aikacin gwamnati ne.
You might be a farmer in this place.
Zai iya zama na kai manomi ne.
You might be doing anything.
Zai iya zama kana abubuwa aiki.
Devil can still tempt you in that.
Shedan zai iya zuwa ya jarabce ka akan shi.
But anytime he tempts you in that.
Amma duk lokacin da ya jarabce ka akan wannan.
Remember that he's just trying to take you away from the kingdom of God.
Ka tuna cewa yana so ya dauke ka ne daga cikin mulkin Ubangiji.
Do your best.
Ka yi iyakan kokarin ka.
Resist him even to the shedding of your blood.
Ka gudu ka kishi ko da karshen jinin ka ne.
So that tomorrow me and you can meet together in heaven.
Saboda gobe ni da kai mu sadu a sama.
Can you pray in 1 minute?
Za ku yi addu'a cikin minti daya.
And say, oh God,
Allah,
may anything that is hindering me from the kingdom of God, today I let it go. Is it lie? Is it fornication? Is it adultery? Is it stealing? Is it witchcraft? Is it strife? Is it anger? Is it malice? Is it pride? Is it arrogance? Can you tell God in your heart and say, God, help me? Lord Jesus, come into my heart and help me. Today I believe in you.
Yes,
that you die for myself. And you rise for myself. I will forever live to praise you. Amen.
Amen.
Last scripture before